Got a new face here, a couple new faces, I love it. We got a couple not here, but we all right. We all right. So, I'm glad to see y'all. I got just a couple announcements. December, I was gonna say July, don't ask me why. But December the 7th is Family of Faith, and we're having hash and onion rings and hush puppies and whatever desserts everybody brings. Then on the 11th of December is our Christmas / Thanksgiving dinner. You know, we do it in between, and that's being catered by Meemaw's Kitchen. And we're still collecting toys for tots. We got a box back there for that, and we're done on the 5th is the last day we can take stuff for that. And we do have a blessing box out there. People still been using it. They're using it better than they were, let's put it that way. So it's working out good. And we do have a box back there if anybody want to bring any non-perishable things in to keep adding to that. Other than that, we have choir practice at 4:00. Tonight's service is at 5:00. Wednesday night service is at 6:00. That's it.
Unless I missed something. Think of anything else?
My ordination will be on the 5th of December. So, other than that, I think that's all we got. I'll turn it over to our next meeting.
Let's see, page 430, you can use your book, you can use the words up there.
Amen. Thank you. His heart was broken, mine was mended. He became sin, now I am clean.
Amen.
The cross he carried bore my burden. The nails that held him set me free. His life for mine, his life for mine. How could it ever be that he would die? God's Son would die to save a wretch like me.
Now, I'm just going to tell y'all, I don't know if I can top that one or not. I don't know if I can do that or not, but I'm going to do what God put on my heart and see what happens. I'm speaking today out of the book of John, chapter 11. I wasn't planning on doing this message. I told Ted earlier this morning. I had something else in mind, and when I was finishing that up, God laid this on my heart, so I decided to go this route instead. I'm going to cover a whole lot more than what I normally would. I normally cover a few verses, But as y'all probably see up there, there's quite a few verses up there. We're going to talk about Lazarus. And I thought it was a story that we should go through the whole thing all one time. So I'm going to condense this. This is probably like a 3-message sermon, but I'm not going to be up here for an hour and a half, y'all. I ain't going to do that to you. But I'm going to try to condense it all in together. So, but I'm going to read verse 4 first. This is after Lazarus' sisters had sent a message to Jesus saying that he was sick. And it says that when Jesus heard that, he said, "This sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God, that the Son of God might be glorified thereby." He's going to use that sickness to glorify him, to glorify Jesus and God. So he waited. You know, he waited. Even if he left right then, Lazarus still would have died because of how long it took him to get there. But he wanted him to be, how can I say this, good and dead. You know, he wanted him to be dead, dead. I know that sounds awful, but when he did his miracle, he wanted everybody to know he did a miracle. Not just, well, he might have been just laying there asleep. He might have been just up in that cave laying down. No, no, no. He wanted everyone to realize what he was about to do. So then here in verse, I'm going to read 21 through 27. And it says, "Then said Martha to Jesus, Lord, if thou hast been there here, my brother had not died. But I know that even now, whatsoever thou wilt ask of God, God will give it thee. Jesus said unto her, thy brother shall rise again. Martha said unto him, I know that he shall rise again in the resurrection at the last day. Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live.
Amen.
And whoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believest thou this? She said unto him, Ye Lord, I believe that thou art the Christ, the Son of God, which should come into the world. She said, if you believe in me, there is no death. There's everlasting life believing in Jesus. What he's saying right there is, if you die before he comes back, you're going to get you a new body, and he's going to come back and get the ones that are alive. The ones that are alive never going to die. You know, I want to go to heaven, but it sounds better to me to go to the resurrection than to die. You know, just get lifted up and go. It sounds good, don't it?
Yeah.
That sounds better, don't it? So, but either way, you're going to heaven if you believe in Jesus.
Amen.
Either way. So that's just powerful words. That right there, I got to read that one more time. I am the resurrection and the life. Woo. Tell me that's not good. That's good stuff right there, folks. That's why I had to go through this all, because I didn't want to just break this up. Because I just felt like God said, put it all out there at one time. So that's what I'm doing. I'm putting it out there. In the fourth chapter that I read first, John mentioned the word Jesus. He mentioned it 24 times in the 11th chapter. John says the name Jesus more than Mark, Luke, or Matthew. All say it. John used Jesus a lot. He uses a lot. And that just, to me, that should be, I wanted y'all to get y'all some information to help out. Just, you know, you should know those things. So, but John used the word Jesus more than the other three did. So, but I'm going to go ahead and read the 33 through 44. When Jesus therefore saw her weeping, and the Jews also weeping, which came with her, he groaned in the spirit and was troubled. And he said, where have ye laid him? They said unto him, Lord, come and see. And Jesus wept. It's known as Jesus wept is known as the shortest verse in the English Bible, English translated Bible. That shows his emotion. Jesus was 100% God while being 100% man at the same time.
That's right.
And he showed his emotion by crying. He grieved with them, with the other Jewish people and with his sisters. That was showing him grieving. We all grieve when we lose somebody, right? It's awful. It's awful. It's painful. It hurts. I know it does. I've been there. You know, we all been there. But Jesus shows his emotions and showing that he is human by him saying, you know, where it says right here, Jesus wept. And that's just powerful to know that he can be still 100% God and be 100% man at the same time. Okay? So he was grieving with them. Then said the Jews, behold, how he loved him. That even showed that he loved him. So that's showing another emotion. You know, so Jesus loved and he cried. There's nowhere in the Bible you can find where Jesus laughed, but you can find other spots where he cried. He did show that emotion, but he never in his Bible talks about him laughing. And some of them said, could not this man which opened the eyes of the blind have caused that even this man should have not have died? Jesus, therefore, again groaning in himself, coming to the grave, it was a cave, and a stone lay upon it. This is the first time that we're going to have a stone move here in a little bit. Later in this chapter, we're going to talk about later on about another stone being moved. But that's another story for another day. But I just wanted to mention that. So, Jesus said, take ye away the stone, Martha, the sister of him that was dead, said unto him, Lord, by this time he stinketh, for he hath been dead 4 days. He's been gone 4 days now. Been up in that cave 4 days. Jesus said unto her, said, I not unto thee that if thou wouldest believe, thou shouldest see the glory of God. If you believe, you will see the glory of God. And that's the same with everyone here. If we got something going on with us, if we believe in God, he can take care of us. No matter what it is, you just have to believe. That's the key to everything, is believing. Then they took away the stone from the place where the dead was laid. And Jesus lifted up his eyes and said, Father, I thank thee that thou hast heard me. So he knew he done healed him. He knew he done brought him up out of death. Okay? And I knew that thou hearest me always, but because of the people which stand by, I said it, that they may believe that thou hast sent me. He knew that God heard his prayers. And I'm going to tell y'all, God hears your prayers too. He hears them, but he will answer them in his time.
Yeah, that's right.
It's always his time. It's not our time. We are impatient people. We want stuff right now. We got to wait on God. Mm-hmm. Slow your roll and wait on God, because he will come through for every last one of us. I'm telling you. So then, and when he thus had spoken, he cried with a loud voice, Lazarus, come forth. And he sat and he that was dead come forth, bound hand and foot with grave clothes, and his face, and was bound with a napkin. Jesus said unto them, loose him and let him go. Loose him and let him go. Lazarus come walking up out of the cave. Lazarus ain't dead no more. Lazarus done got up. He waited 4 days to let everybody know that he did create a miracle. Jesus could have rolled that stone away. Jesus could have went, stone gone.
Right.
He could have said, got him released. He didn't want to do that. Why? Because man can do that. He want to do it to create a miracle. If Jesus does a miracle, he wants everybody to know it's a miracle. Okay? Any man, men, all the men can roll that stone away. Them men can untie him. But them men couldn't get him up. Okay? That's why he didn't do those things. He wanted to make sure everybody understood that I'm God. And I can heal you, or I can get you, bring you back to life. And through Jesus, you have ever everlasting life. You said it earlier this morning. See how things tie together? God ties stuff together even though we don't know what's going to. But that is what God did. That's what Jesus did. He brought back the dead. If you can bring back the dead, there's nothing in your life that he can't accomplish. He can't fix in you.
That's right.
There's nothing he can't fix. I'm telling you. As I look up through here, I see sick people all the way up through here. I look over here, I see sick people over here. But y'all trust in Jesus, I'm trying to tell you. He can heal us. He can heal us. I look in the mirror every morning, I see a sick person, ain't that right?
Amen.
You know, but God can heal us, I'm telling you.
Yeah.
You just gotta believe. You just gotta believe. You just gotta trust in Jesus. Because he is the way. You know, he just is. There's a lot of people, a lot of Christians, that are still bound, okay? Their hands are still bound. Their hands are bound, so they can't work. Their feet are bound, so they can't walk, okay? That's Christians. And I say about working, that means just getting out there, trying to win souls for God, for Jesus. That's our job, you know? We're supposed to be, our mouths are bound. That stops us from witnessing. We all got something to say. We all have a testimony.
That's right.
Ain't that right, Brother David? You got a testimony, don't you?
That's right.
All right. We all got one. And that's what helps bring people to Jesus. And I'm so thankful this morning to see 5 new faces out here that I haven't seen. I've been praying for that. And I'm thanking God for y'all coming this morning.
Amen.
Every last one of y'all. I thank y'all so much for coming. Amen. And giving this church an opportunity this morning.
Amen.
Amen.
An opportunity to win.
Exactly. Exactly. So I thank God for that. I thank God for y'all. I do. But like I said, there is nothing that Jesus can't accomplish. And I'm sure of it. I'm sure of it. So, like I said, I cut as short as I could because I needed to get all of that out this morning. All of it. So I wanted to get through it. I really don't know why. Because I thought about breaking it down in 3 sermons. But I just wanted to cram it all together in one. In one. I don't know why, but that's what God told me to do. So I try to do what he told me to do.
Amen.
When I do what I want to do, it don't never work out very good.
Right.
But if I do what God tells me to do,
yeah,
it works out a whole lot better.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying?
Right.
So I try to do whatever he wants me to do. However long or however short anything is, I try to do what God puts on my heart to give to y'all. Because I'm a servant. And the day I see Jesus, I just want to say, here I am, Father.
Sick man ain't going to be there no more, is he?
Sick man ain't here no more. Sick man ain't here no more. But I'm here, Jesus, and I'm here to serve. Whatever you want me to do, I'll do. Whatever you want me to do, I'll do. But I'm here to serve you. And I want y'all to be there to serve him too. They got ready to sing a hymn of invitation. And I just want y'all to know that I love every one of y'all, and I'm glad y'all here today. But the doors of the church are open. If you don't know Jesus, come on down right now and I can introduce you to him. I can't save you, but I know the man who can.
Amen.
And I can introduce you to him.
Thank you.
Thank you, Heavenly Father, for this day. Thank you for everything that you've done for us. Thank you for putting a shield of protection around us and keeping us all safe in this crazy world today. Father, I ask you to just be with everyone here, pour blessings upon them and this church, and just keep them safe. And Father, if there's anyone who's not saved, let today be the day they accept your Son, Father. And if not, at least give them another opportunity to accept your Son before it's eternally too late. And I ask all in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.